my auto, just a nuclear reactor.
Exactly, stop it, then it's cracked.
Thank you. With oil interest cluster, the U.S. Gulf Coast, all eyes and hopes are on a giant concrete and steel dome designed to cap the leak from a sunken rig that's spewing some 200,000 gallons of crude each day. CNN's Brooke Baldwin is on the Gulf Coast watching it all unfold for us. Brooke, what is this containment dome? How does it work?
Well, think of this containment dome as a big, massive metal concrete funnel. And the best way I can sort of explain it is by demonstrating. Imagine you have a funnel just like this. This funnel, this concrete dome, is being taken right now from what I'm hearing. It's sort of just now exiting Port Fouchon right now out of Louisiana and entering the big waters here out on the Gulf. It will continue for about 50 miles offshore to the leak location. And then what will happen is they'll take a system of piping, so like a straw, for example. They'll put the piping inside of this containment dome, and then with a ship out above, they'll be able to siphon or essentially suck up what may be 85% of this oil that's leaking. What's key here is that BP has never performed an operation at this depth of water, 5,000 feet under, but this is a first for them. So keep in mind, they did have one well this morning, but of course that means the volume of the gush has not changed. It's still spilling 210,000 gallons every day.
Well, we're hearing the oil is still about 2 miles from shore, but it could end within 72 hours. Talk a little bit about what you're hearing from experts about wildlife and the ecosystem in that whole area.
Right, it's devastating. You just heard Jack talk about it. And what's interesting is there are all kinds of species, 400 different species of wildlife out here. And I was fortunate enough, the second I landed here in Mississippi yesterday, I was back up in the air in a helicopter taking a look around some of these barrier islands off of Mississippi, because what I didn't realize